real life situation which we apply in the life, and to frame questions based on real life situations and surroundings. Okay, basically, yes, Gitanjali, you have rightly said we have to find solution of the questions which are based on the given situation. Okay, we are getting detailed study of any subject, keen observation of situation, real life situation based questions, analysis we do. Yes, you are rightly said, Aarti, analysis we do in such case studies. So when we say that we are talking about a case study, some specific words come here closely in reference to a case study. When we say we need to study a case, what is that case? A case can be any analysis, any individual, or it is in reference to any particular situation. Brilliant. I am receiving lots and lots of good answers. You will be receiving the copy of this chat so that you can refer to the responses shared by all the participants. Yes, it is intensive study about anything. Basically, you see, you are going deeper into some certain specific situation. So, my dear friends, today we are doing this capacity building program for secondary mathematics teachers who belong to DAV schools. And specifically today, we are meeting secondary group mathematics teachers of cluster C1 to C4. As you can see here on the screen, I have flashed a schedule of the today's program. We already have finished with session one on framing innovative questions and case study based discussions by Ms. Anita Sharma, principal of ST Public School, and she is a CBSE resource person. Now I would be doing some discussions with all of you on changes in CBSE exam paper and case study based questions. Then there will be a break at 11 a.m. till 11:30. You can enjoy the tea at home. And then you will be joining back at 11 questions, creative questions based on situations in geometry. At 12:30, we would be meeting the resource person, our own master trainer, Miss Anju Nirula from DAV Pushpanjali. And because, you know, in DAV schools, we need to follow certain design and blueprint of a paper for class 9. And she would be giving insight about class 9 blueprints for the final exam paper. And she has done a beautiful analysis of grade 10 CBSE paper of previous session and the new. So this will be the whole thing which we would be doing today. Now, certain important things which I would like to share with all of you, that link of attendance is provided to you already, and this was there in the document which must have been shared with all of you and your respective master trainers of the different clusters. I really appreciate each of the master trainer who has designed this beautiful program, and from they must have shared with you the document in which the link of attendance and link of the feedback has been provided to all of you. After that, please ensure that today you are going to perform a teacher activity. If you find time while taking up the session, well and good, there is no problem in it. But if you are not able to finish it, please ensure that, number one, you have submitted a case study based question along with the MCQ which has been allotted to your school, and the link of that sheet has already been shared with you. And next thing, you need to review case study, at least three. One allotted to the school and remaining you can choose any. For that, in the WhatsApp group which I have mentioned of C1 to C4, I have shared the link of two interesting things. Number one, the teacher folder SEC Maths CBP 7/11/2020. In this folder, you will find interesting stuff. The CBSE has provided certain useful books. You can refer to those books. Number two, in that those books, you will find interesting assessment-based questions which you can give to your students. And then you will find in that particular folder the sample papers which have been provided by CBSE along with the marking scheme. If you wish to share those contents with the students, you can do that. Then there is a review performer. Review performer, if you go on this, this is a Google form where you will be filling the review of the case study which you have done. So where you will find these case studies, the case studies will be provided in the document, in the sheet. Each school has given certain good case studies, so you have to review them and give your remarks. And if you create the new questions related to those particular case studies, please you do that as well. I would like to share with you the process, basically how you're going to submit that. It would be nice if on your desktop you can create a folder by your name, and in that folder you can have a document. In that document you can write down your suggestions and remarks of the case study which you are going to review, and then you need to attach that particular document in the add file section of this review performer. So I am not clicking on these particular links. The reason being, now you are all experts in using these simple technologies. Okay, another interesting thing which you will be now doing is add your pictures or responses in the Google Photos album. You can take your selfie, the place where you are sitting and doing your work. You can take picture of the screenshots and then put it here. And whatever activity which we would be doing in another 40 minutes, you can share your work in this particular Google Photos link. Now, coming back to the session. My dear students, we would be exploring now some interesting case studies, and we would be now exploring how we are going to create new set of questions based on those case studies. So you all are aware, I would say we all are aware, that CBSE has changed the pattern of class 10 mathematics examination 2020-21. And you all must have seen this, that how many sections will be there, in each section what type of questions will be there, then how many choices will be available to the students. And till now you all have seen the sample paper which has been provided by the CBSE. So our focus is not on discussing those questions or discussing the sample paper. Our focus is how you are going to train your students, guide your students, and facilitate learning in the classroom.
Excuse me, Rashmi ma'am, I am YNC Srimati from Navy Public School, Chennai. I just want a small clarification in that sample paper. Actually, part B consists of 2 marks, 3 marks, and 5 marks, isn't it? But yes, they didn't mention section 3, section 4, section 5. Can we mention like that? Otherwise, everything comes under part B.
Yes,
okay,
please. Yes, please. For that, I would suggest, ma'am, that you write your suggestion and please share it here. We will forward it to the CBSE, right? You please write down your suggestion here in the chat box. Okay. Now, okay, I'm proceeding further. I request all of you to kindly mute your microphones. Thank you so much. Okay. Now, my dear friends, we started in the first session about the case study based questions, and Anita ma'am rightly said that we need to build up variety of skills in the students, and for that we are taking up this particular set of questions. Earlier, you know, we are giving a 5 marks question and the children were doing it. So the great idea which has been shared by Anita ma'am is that you take up a long question, break it into sub parts, and try to think what kind of smaller, simpler questions you can make out of that situation. And children can write down even the things which are coming up in between, that is smaller calculations or smaller observations which we are going to make up in a particular question. Now, you see, when we talk about a case study based question, first thing is we are provided with the information related to any given topic. So when I say any given topic, it does not mean that it is related to the syllabus. It might be something which is connected with the syllabus. Like if you see, there are certain bridges which are built up. So if you go into a theme called mathematics and architecture, so first idea which I am sharing with all of you, that you can explore on Google different kinds of architectures which have been made or which are inspired by mathematics. We did a good project in our school few years ago, mathematics and architecture. I hope all of you, some DAV schools who participated, I think 12 schools were there, they realized that in the monuments and in the architectures, when we create different maps, when we think of building different floors or different kinds of structures one above the other, then we need to apply a lot of mathematics, a lot of geometry. We have to think about trigonometry and much more. The scope is infinite. So I would now give you some time to search on Google mathematics architectures inspired by mathematics. And then I have shared with you a Google Photos link, which I told a few minutes ago. I'm talking about this. Add your picture or responses. Then you can add that picture in this particular photo album. At the end of the session, we will see what kinds of questions we can frame related to that particular monument or that particular building or that particular layout. Interesting glass houses and lots and lots of buildings. I remember there is a Cubes village in Netherlands. If you search, you will be amazed to see the entire village has been created using the cube houses. So you will be finding lots and lots of insight of creating questions based on shapes which we see and the kind of concepts which we apply on those particular monuments or the different architectures. So that is the one thing which I wanted to share with you. So side by side, you can keep on exploring in the different tab, one activity which I've given to you, then you have to look for mathematical architectures which are inspired by mathematics. Now, another thing which I mentioned in the first statement, that you are provided with information related to given topic. So you must have explored the case studies which CBSE has already provided. They have explained about the concept of parabola, and then they have taken up a bridge, and then the arch is in the shape of a parabola, and then they have framed five beautiful questions based on that particular case study, right? So another thing which we can look at in the formation of a case study based question is that some situation is given. Now you will be surprised, like some people say, if I ask what is a case study based question, they say we need to be given some paragraph and we need to comprehend it, and then we have to answer certain questions. My dear friends, this is one type of a case study based question. It might be a text is given, it might be some picture is given, some graph is given, some table of data is provided to you, and then on the basis of that, some five questions have been framed. So basically, we need to see application and connection of mathematics in daily life situations. So these are the three key insights about framing case study based questions. Okay, now the purpose is all set, purpose is all clear. In the previous session, we have understood this in a deeper way, that we have to make productive learners. And if you go through the purpose of studying mathematics, so it is mathematization of the mind. So basically, we have to charge up the mind. We have to build up a lot of skills like mathematical thinking, critical thinking, problem solving, creative thinking. We have to increase the power of observation and then comprehending the situation, analyzing the situation, and the child is able to do and apply lots and lots of other skills, skills of estimation and things like that. Now you have seen that when we closely observe this teaching learning of mathematics, so teaching learning of mathematics, then we normally in a classroom, we talk about vocabulary. There is a particular vocabulary in a math classroom. Second, we talk about concepts and processes. We teach them how you do this process, how you find LCM, HCF, how you apply the concept of similarity, or how you use the Pythagoras theorem. So processes you explain to them, right? And then children, they do the problem solving. After that, if you now see, there is a fourth pillar which has been added, and that is connection of maths in daily life, which we are going to achieve using such kinds of questions. Okay, let us begin with this case study. Now, I can see the chat box. I would request all of you to use this effectively. Now, my first question to all of you is, looking at this picture, I'm not talking about the text which has been written. So just look at this picture and tell me from which chapter you can frame a question.
Arithmetic progression.
Yes, it is a humble request. Use the chat box. I can read the chats. It would be nice if you mute your microphone. Yes, thank you so much. You see, if there are 125 people, I am getting one Anshu Arora is different. Rest, okay, I got another response. Mr. Nagendra is saying coordinate geometry. Radha is saying surface area and volume. Wonderful. Akshay is saying mensuration. Vasudha is saying mensuration. You see, you started with, by looking at the pattern, arithmetic progression, right? So first thing which comes to your mind is arithmetic progression. Okay, but after that, I have seen that some of you have mentioned surface area and volume, and you are talking about similar triangles. That's interesting. Okay, so get ready with your notebook and pen, because you would be now taking pictures and adding that picture in the Google Photos link, which I have shared with you. So I will be looking at all those responses. So get ready with your notebook and pen, and please do not forget to write your name on the submission, right? You can write your name. Okay, congruency, perfectly fine. So we would be starting the discussion now. See this, according in this case study, it is given that Miss Malini goes to a grocery shop for purchasing some glass jars for gifting in a party. Okay, interesting. Somebody has written profit and loss, congruency, and Pascal triangle. Okay, we will look into this. So Miss Malini goes to a grocery shop for purchasing some glass jars for gifting in a party. She observed that the jars are arranged one above the other in a specific pattern. So here actually deliberately the pattern of numbers has been provided. So 3, 6, 9, so on. So you can now very well imagine on the top three jars, you can see then 6, then 9, and so on. And then on the basis of this, certain questions have been asked. Okay, the first question is, please start solving. How many total jars are there? I'm waiting for reply in the chat box. Just solve. You are given the sequence 3, 6, 9, so on. Now you can see how many rows are there. And then you need to write down how many total jars are there. This is a new case study. You will not find it in CBSE book. I have recorded a video of this also. I will be providing the list of videos, recorded videos, to all of you. And you can find that document in the teacher folder, which I've shared with you. Okay, one answer I'm getting 24, another I'm getting 108. Okay, I would like Reena Ahuja to explain the answer. Miss Reena Ahuja, you can unmute yourself.
Okay, ma'am. The number of rows are 8, right?
Okay.
And the first term is 3, and the common difference is also equals to 3. So we will use the sum of n terms formula to find the total number of jars.
Okay.
And so that comes to 108.
Yes,
that Rupali comes out to 108.
Okay, Rupali ma'am has shared the link of the Google Photos album over here. I will tell you what you are going to add in that, right? Okay, so answer to this question is right. 108 is the correct answer. So here you can see that first, last term can be found. Last term can be found, and child can use the formula n by 2 a plus l. And the answer can be known, and it is 108. Perfectly fine. Okay, now the second question is, if there are 100 such rows, now you see, the picture is reflecting one information. Now we are taking child's imagination to the other level. If there are 100 such rows, then how many jars will be in the 56th row? Yes, try to solve this question. अगर हमारे पास 100 ऐसी rows हैं, तो कितनी jars होंगे 56th row में? So you see, observation is playing a key role here. That is important. And second thing is imagination. So we are now, yes, what is the answer? 168. 168 is the correct answer. You are basically to calculate T56. I would request Sandhya Arora ma'am to please explain. And you just tell me, Sandhya ma'am, kitna time laga aapko ise karne mein, quickly karne mein. Okay, Charupant ma'am, please share.
Yes, ma'am. Because they are asking us to find out the number of jars in the 56th row, so we are going to apply the formula an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d.
Right.
And by using that formula, yes, we are going to get the answer as 168, since we have first term as 3 and the common difference again as 3. So we have to find out the number of jars in the 56th row, that is A56.
Okay, Charu ma'am, can you frame a similar set of question like we have framed here, where we are testing the similar knowledge? Framing a new question. Yes.
We can like similar.
We have given a child that there are 100 such rows.
Yes, ma'am, we can give a different number of rows over here, and then we can accordingly find out how many jars are going to be there in we can give 60th row, we can give some other number over there.
Right, you are very right. So basically, I have got one reply from Aarti ma'am. If there are 200 rows, then how many jars are there in 80th row?
Yes.
Okay, so things
ma'am,
like,
can I frame one question?
Yes, please.
How many jars are there in the last row?
Oh, yes, that is a wonderful question. That, do you know, if we ask this question, what is the reply? How many jars are there in the last row?
The value of n must be 100, the value of first term must be 3, and the value of the common difference is 3. Then they will apply the formula A100 is equal to A plus 99D, and they will find out the number of rows in the last number of jars in the last row.
Perfectly fine. So you see how you can frame a question on the basis of observation. See, picture is given, but we are trying to frame new questions. At present also we have framed 3 new questions. Okay, moving on to next. Just observe this, and this is the very clear cut simple question. If on the top so basically we are testing the knowledge of the children, that the children have understanding of the concept of arithmetic sequence or not. Yes, what is the answer for that? You
excuse
need to
me,
read
ma'am.
All 4 replies. You can write the answer in the chat box. Okay, I'm getting the answers from people.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, whether here the first row, first A will be here 3 or 300, since the first row cannot contain 3 jars here. The first row, if we are having 100 rows, since in the first row we will be having 300 jars, then 297, so it will go in the descending order. Otherwise, this pyramid cannot be formed.
Here I'm talking about this particular frame which is given, right? If on the top in this particular diagram.
Okay, ma'am.
Right? So in this particular diagram, if we put 2 jars, then after that we put 1 more jar, then you need to tell whether you get an arithmetic sequence or not.
Ma'am, I was talking about the previous question. Since you have asked how many jars will be there in the...
So the first answer is... What is the answer? You are saying B part. Yes, common difference between the 2 consecutive terms should be same, but here you are not getting that. Right. Okay, let us move on to the next one now. Now, in this particular question, you can see some of you mentioned that we can ask questions related to volume and surface area. Right. Here, see what I have done. Here, Miss Malini asked the shopkeeper to pack this arrangement in the same fashion as it was displayed. And the shopkeeper used a box of the dimensions as shown in the diagram. So front face of the box is an equilateral triangle. And it is given that each side is here of a triangle is 24 centimeters. And then find the capacity of the box used. We can ask a simple question like, what is the shape of this box? If you want to make a paper for basic paper. For standard, you can ask some other questions, right? Okay, tell me what will be the answer in this case. So there is a box which has a specific shape. What is the shape of this box? You can write in the chat box. More specific, which type of a prism, sir? Lalit sir? Yes, it's a triangular prism. So what is the answer? You are getting the D part as the answer. So here you are getting one clue from the choices. It is not required that you are giving the full answer. You can give the in between calculations also. You see here, I have not multiplied root 3 by the particular answer. So 1440 into 1.7. Our objective is not to check the calculation. Our objective is to see whether child is able to comprehend, child is able to observe, child is able to apply the knowledge, and the child has understanding of that particular concept, right? So D part is the correct answer. I can see many of you have done this. Wonderful. Okay, now moving on to the next question. Let us see. If we try to pack it in some other shaped box. Now my question to all of you is, what kind of question can be framed in this particular situation? You can please frame the question and type in the chat box. What kind of a question can be given? And in place of this, I could have a cylindrical box also. So triangular prism box, we have taken cuboidal box. Yes, volume of the box we can ask. And if we have to wrap it with a gift paper, then what will be the total paper, amount of paper which we are going to use? Yes, surface area, total surface area of the box. So that will give us the paper used for covering this particular box. So basically you need to give the dimensions and then you can frame as many questions based on the given case study. Perfectly fine. So moving on to next, this is another case study. Okay, this is case study number 2, and you see here also an interesting problem is given. It is basically showing, yes, Meenakshi, you are right, volume of the remaining portion. That is a very interesting input for the previous question. You can share that question, write that question on the piece of paper, take a picture and upload in that Google Photo link, which I have shared with all of you. Okay, let us discuss the next case study. It says, this is also a new case study. Money saving pattern of 3 friends, Shriya, Gauri, and Manak, is here given below in the table. So they started saving the money from the first week of May 2019. And money saved by each one of them is recorded. Right. So you can observe that Shriya, Gauri, and Manak, they started in the week 1 and they started with rupee 10. In week 2, Shriya saved rupee 12, Gauri saved rupee 13, and then Manak saved rupee 14. So you see the pattern is changing. In week 3, Shriya saved rupees 14. Gauri saved rupees 16 and Manak saved rupees 18. Okay, similarly, the readings are given for week 4. And interestingly, you will notice that a pattern is given. After that, a condition is also given. And the condition says, Shriya continued saving the money till 15 weeks. Right? And Gauri saved the money till 12 weeks. And Manak saved the money till 10 weeks. Right? So this is the information which is given to you. Okay, my first question, you see, you are writing your observations, which is very good. Now Anshu Arora. Anshu, you have mentioned bar graph here. Can you please share your idea?
Actually, ma'am, bar graph can be asked, but it can be a long question. So I'm adding the short questions also, that how much money will be saved by Gauri in third week, by Manak in second week. Many type of questions can be asked. Probability related questions can be asked as well as it is an AP. So we can, I think 10, 12, their difference is 2. Mm-hmm. So related questions can be asked.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. Okay, Mr. Vikas, you have written probability and AP. Can you please share your insight? What are you thinking about this situation?
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, I would like to share that regarding probability, the questions can be framed like, what is the probability that in week number 2 that Gauri has saved 13 rupees? What is the probability that in week number 3 Gauri and Manak both have saved some amount? Then regarding regarding AP, there is some sequence given, and further it is also given that full question in the first week of May. So regarding this AP also, questions can be framed from here, ma'am.
So that's
weeks
are
given, like till 15 weeks, till 12 weeks, and till 10 weeks.
Okay, so I would request you, sir, to please frame some questions, take a picture, and please share in that album. Okay, we will review those questions.
Sure.
Okay.
Ma'am.
Yes, thank you so much. And Deepthi Mehta, please share your insight. This is a very good question, that who saved more money by the end of 10 weeks? Yes, Deepthi.
Yeah, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
We can actually give the number of weeks to the children, and then we can ask them to just find out the amount saved by each of them, and then compare who saved more money or who saved less money. We can put in questions like that also.
Wonderful, wonderful. That's a great question. Please frame one question on the same line which you have thought. You see, scientifically, it has been proved that each brain is unique. And we are really fortunate at present, 127 people are working together and we are thinking, and all of us are able to now frame few questions based on the same situation which has been shared with us, right? That's a great thing. Okay, so Ms. Meenakshi, please share your insight. You have written total money saved by each using AP. So what questions you are thinking of framing? Okay, Miss Anju Gupta.
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, in up to how much money will be saved by Manak in till 10th week? We can find this, and means SN can be found in this question.
Very good. SN can be found.
We can compare, we can draw the bar graph, frequency, polygon, or we can compare, we can find the difference also. Up to 4th week, Gauri and Shreya, mein kitna difference tha. So many questions related to that.
Okay. So let us see what 5 questions we have framed here, and we can solve it together. So first question is, how much money was saved by Shreya in the 15th week? Yes, please. Give me the answer. How much money was saved by Shreya in the 15th week? So you can catch up the saving money pattern of Shreya. 10, 12, 14, 16. In the 15th week. So reading of question is very important here. How much money? There is a difference. How much total money was saved till the 15th week? And here the question is, how much money was saved by Shreya in the 15th week? Okay, you are getting the answer. 28. So let us see the answer. Yes, you are right. So T15 is A plus 14D. We can simplify, put the values. Here the first term is coming out to be 10. And common difference is 2 for Shreya's saving pattern. So we get the answer as 38. Very good. Moving on to the next question. How much total money was saved by Shreya? Now see, the previous question was in the 15th week. Now the question is, how much total money was saved by Shreya? So the children have to understand the difference between the two statements. So here again, we are testing the comprehension and knowledge and understanding of the concept. Okay, I'm getting quick answers. That is wonderful. Yes, please try to solve. Okay, 360 is the answer. So S15 you have found. n by 2 into a plus l using that formula. So number of terms is 15. First term is 10. Last term is 38. Why I've used it, I have already calculated in the previous question. So it is wise to use that. And we get the answer as a part, that is 360. Wonderful. Moving on to the next question. How much money was saved by Manak in the ninth week? Now you see the pattern of Manak, which has been shared with you. Manak started with rupee 10, and in each consecutive week, he saved 4 rupee more. So 10, then 14, then 18, and so on. So you need to tell how much money was saved by Manak in the ninth week. Very simple calculations are there. You will always find that the questions are not asked, difficult questions are not asked, but it is indicating the understanding, level of understanding and application of the concept, right? So the answer, correct answer is 42. Perfectly fine. Good, all of you are able to do this. Now moving on to next question. This is interesting. You have to think and do it. Who out of Shriya and Manak saved more money and by how much? Shriya or Manak mein se kisne zyada money save ki aur kitni zyada save ki? It is up to the last. When a case study is given, you need to tell the children. If nothing is mentioned, no condition is mentioned, then you need to see till last you have to perform all of operations. Who out of Shriya and Manak saved more money and by how much? I have got two different answers. Raj sir is saying Manak ne save kiya hai. And the remaining two people, Varun and Lalit, are saying D part. Okay, Varun sir, please explain.
Yes, excuse me, ma'am.
Hanji, please.
Actually, I have joined from my son's account.
Okay, I'm fine. No problem.
Okay. Shreya will save after 15 weeks 360 rupees.
Okay.
And Manak will save 280 rupees.
Okay. So the correct answer is coming out to be D part.
D.
Okay.
Yes.
Raj sir, how come your answer is coming to be Manak? What logic you have applied? Yes, D part is the correct answer. Perfectly fine. Okay, fifth question is a little tricky. You just read the question carefully. If Shriya's saving is maximum, okay, and then after how many weeks Gauri's saving will exceed Shriya's saving? So basically here, Gauri has to continue saving for more number of weeks. So that has been asked. So if Shriya's saving is maximum, then after how many weeks Gauri's saving will exceed Shriya's saving? The data is, you can remember, like three patterns are there. All of them are starting with 10. Then 10, 12, a gap of 2. And then 10, 13, a gap of 3. And then 10, 14, a gap of 4 has been provided. So Shriya, Gauri, and Manak. So you can use that information and tell me if Shriya's saving is the maximum, then after how many weeks Gauri's savings will exceed Shriya's saving? What is the answer? If you wish to see the table is here. Okay, Anju ma'am, you can please unmute and share your response, how you have got the answer.
Good morning.
Yes, please.
Actually, we have already calculated that Shreya has 360 rupees, she has saved, and then Gauri has saved 318, then I subtracted the two, I got 42, and if she saves for two more weeks, then he will be getting more than Shreya.
So what will be the answer?
Two more weeks.
Okay, anybody else who has tried? She has to save for two more weeks? Okay, you tell me one thing here. You have already found Shreya's saving, that is rupees 360 in 15 weeks. So what is the Gauri's saving? What is T12? T12 is, if you calculate, it is A plus 11D, and that comes out to be 43. So what will be S12? That comes out to be 318. Okay, Lalit is saying C part is the correct answer. Anybody who would like to say which is the right one, B or C? You can write your response in the chat box. Then we will have the discussion. Lalit sir, you can explain your answer, please.
Is according to what they do there, within 2 weeks, the money of I.
Sir, your voice is not audible actually. Please write in the chat box. We can read the message.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, yes, anybody who is ready for the discussion, please write in the chat box. What is your answer? A, B, C, or D? Okay, now read the question here. It is given that Gauri saves up to 12 weeks. So till 12 weeks, what is her total saving? And what is the saving of the 12th week? That is important. And then tell me the answer. Okay, that's interesting. She's saying A part is the answer.
Yes, A part is the correct answer.
You see, I am getting so many good responses. Abhi dekho koi D part bhi likh do. हमारे को पता लगा B correct है, कोई कहता C correct है. अब बहुत सारे लोग कह रहे A correct है. Let us have the discussion. Okay, Neetu Gupta ma'am. Mathematics is all about thinking. Ma'am, may I? Yes, please. So your answer is?
Ma'am, part A, one more
part
week.
A. Okay, explain the process which you have used.
Ma'am, we have find T12 to be 318. Okay. And then we find T13. And it is coming out to be 46. So 318 plus 46 will be 364. greater than 360, so she needs only one more week for
B part bataya wo. So the correct answer is yahi socha hai is question mein.
Yes, S13 is 264.
T13 is 46. So we will add 46 to 318.
So basically you need to know what is T12 and then T13 and then you need to see the difference.
Yes.
Good. So, wrongly written C. Lalit sir, what is your answer then? So basically you see, it's a simple concept and this is a question which is of higher order thinking skills also. Like we always say that we need to frame questions which invoke thinking and application of the concept. Yahan pe dekho, daily life ki situation bhi aa gayi plus analysis bhi ho gaya. Abhi dekhne se mujhe lag raha hai 2 weeks answer de diya, 3 weeks answer de diya. But after one more week, you will see the saving will be 364 and it is more than Shreya's saving, right? So this is basically, if you see the two case studies which I have shared with you today, both these case studies are new case studies. And in the first case study, we have observed a pattern in terms of a shape, in terms of, you know, arrangement. And now in the second case study, we have observed a pattern which is in terms of numbers. So you will see the difference of choice of question. Number two, you will see the type of question, framing of the question out of the given situation. So now I request all of you to acquire this particular skill of framing question of your own. Now I'm sharing with you the trick and technique. Okay, see how I thought of framing this. I searched on internet, number one, arrangement of jars or placement of packing of Coke tins or packing of tins. And I found a lot of pictures. And on by you looking at those pictures, you can frame a question, right? So if you see the Coke tin or any, you know, a container which is in the form of a right circular cylinder, you can frame questions on the basis of arrangement of n number of tins in a specific pattern, their packing and calculation of their volume or surface area, things like that. So this is one great idea which you can share with the students so that they can practice more such questions. Okay, coming on to the next case study. And quickly, I will be finishing it this up because I have 5 minutes left for the break. So this is case study 3. Ab isme kya diya hua hai? Ki there is a bee which flies after every 3 seconds. Okay, and Mr. Ashok us makhi ko dekh rahe the and he recorded the position of the bee with his magical eyes by the help of a graph shown. Okay, and then he observed the location of the bee at 11 a.m. was recorded at the point B. My dear friends, you can frame your new questions. I have created this particular diagram on GeoGebra and I have taken this picture of makhi from the internet. Okay, so you can take up any, you know, picture of a butterfly or any picture and create some kind of graph on this of a particular equation and then take up different coordinates, different points and frame variety of questions, right? Okay, now you tell me, looking at this, what questions are coming to your mind? Then we will see what simple questions I have taken. Just write in the chat box, aapke dimag mein kya aata hai what kinds of questions can be framed out of this situation. It is given that after 3 seconds, we move from point B to point C. Okay, coordinate and we can use this formula, we can use the exception formula, we can find the abscissa and ordinate of particular coordinates. We can ask the children to find the midpoint of a particular, you know, line segment. Yes, distance formula, distance from the x-axis, different distance from the y-axis, area of triangle. Wonderful observation, Richa. Okay, tell me how you are going to find area of triangle. Which triangle do you want to ask, Richa Baluja?
Ma'am, we can join the 3 points where these B's are lying like.
Okay, then in that case, which formula children would be using for calculating the area?
Ma'am, area of triangle that we used to teach them in class 10, half.
Okay.
Distance from the last one. This time, this formula is not there.
Okay. Half base into high also can be applied. Don't you think so? If we join these 3 points, which are given on the screen, that is B, C, and D, we get a triangle whose base and height can be seen. Right?
So zero is the polynomial, ma'am.
Yes, zero.
And from the vertex C, they draw a perpendicular, they can find out the area through that also.
Oh, yes, they can do that. They can do that. Okay, let us quickly see what all questions I have taken. Number one, what is the distance between the points B and C? Simple application, that is the use of distance formula. So children will be reading the coordinates and calculating the distance. You got the answer as square root of 10, correct answer. Next question, this one is very interesting. Just observe this. After 3 more seconds, the B moved from point C to a point on the x-axis. This is a very interesting question. A point on the x-axis. What can be the possible coordinates of location of the B? 3 seconds ke baad, makhi udkar x-axis pe jaati hai. अब बच्चों को ये पता होना चाहिए कि x एक्सिस पे अगर जाती है मक्खी उड़कर तो कहां कहां पे कौन कौन सी पॉसिबिलिटीज हैं. पॉइंट इक्विडिस्टेंट फ्रॉम सी, पॉइंट सी ऑन द x एक्सिस. सो व्हेन वी सिंप्लीफाई दिस वी गेट सी, द पॉइंट सी इज 1 1. And we take any point on the x-axis as x, 0. So square root of 10 will be equal to, you can write down the, please mute your microphone. Thank you. So we can calculate this. Somebody's mic is on. Yes, thank you. So you see here, root 10 will be equal to square root of x minus 1 whole square plus 0 minus 1 whole square. And when you simplify this, we get x minus whole square as 9. So x minus 1 be plus minus 3. Here the children make the mistake. So we will be getting 2 basic locations of the B. So 4, 0 and minus 2, 0. These are the 2 possible locations of the B on the x-axis, right? Okay, next question. At some point of time, the B sits on the point D. Coordinates of the point which divides C and D in the ratio 1:2. Here again, the application of which formula? Section formula.
Section. Right?
Yes. So you can calculate and you can see that the point lies on the y-axis. So on the basis of the language, you can get the reply. After that, the area of the triangle formed by, like Richa suggested, we can ask the area of triangle B, C, and D. So here what I have, B, D, and origin, right? So what is the area of triangle which is formed by joining B, D, and origin? So here also you can simply calculate half base into height and you can get the answer. And the last question which I have framed is the point on the y-axis which is equidistant from B and C. So on the y-axis, we need to look for a point which is equidistant from B and C. Okay, so my dear friends, I am closing the session. I hope we had a fruitful discussion. I shared with you three case studies. I will be sharing the video discussions of these particular case studies. You will find this document. I am sharing with you the document. This is the playlist of all the videos. And these are the video discussions of the CBSC, all CBSC sample paper case studies, which I have recorded. And you can share it with your students also so that they can insight about discussions. Okay, thank you so much. Have a nice day. We will see you back at 11:30. Bye-bye. Take care.
Rashmi?